Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Board, and then make sure you are subscribed and make sure you got those notifications turned on because we're dropping a lot of videos here on the Raiders Board. A brand new video every single day, and if you want to see your name shouted out on the Raiders Board, try to be one of the very first people that are part of the Noti Gang. What's the Noti Gang? It's the people who are in the comments as soon as the video goes out. So shout out to Untouchable Raider, Junior, Raiderville 13, London Messer, and then S.A. Roderick. Y'all are the real ones. Turn on those notifications, click that bell, and subscribe. Let's go to Ryu. What up, brother? Malcolm Rodriguez is a slept-on linebacker that could be a UDFA. So, linebacker from Oklahoma State. And personally, I don't really see this guy getting drafted. But, yes, maybe he could be a UDFA. I'll also go ahead and say, when I look at a lot of prospects, when I look at linebackers out of the Big 12, sometimes I pump the brakes on them because the tape is hard to get a good feel on them. I will say I am always a little bit more pleasantly surprised by Big 12 linebackers once they go to the NFL, surrounded by more defensive talent, good coaching, and less aired out offenses. Let's go to the flip side with Folk. Do you think the Raiders have a top five receiving core? If I'm looking at just the wide receivers, I'll say no. If I'm talking about the overall just like catching unit, like if I'm going to put Hunter Renfro, Darren Waller, Devontae Adams into that conversation, then I'll say yes. The only reason why I can't put him in the top five is because Devontae is great, Hunter Renfro is great, but Bryan Edwards needs to take that step up. DeMarcus Robinson needs to take that next step as well. Let's go to Ant EZ. A.J. Brown deletes the Titans out of his bio. Could the Raiders trade for him? I love this time of the year, y'all, because you always see crazy rumors like this pop up. A.J. Brown's not coming to the Raiders. And I know I'm probably going to make my title this mailbag A.J. Brown trade related. It's not going to happen. A.J. Brown will not come to the Raiders. But if he does, we're going live. That I can almost guarantee you. Let's go to the next one. We got Robert says, we need three things to make our Super Bowl run. A right tackle, I agree. Wide receiver two and a honey badger. We're not done. Once the draft chips fall with many, we go big June 1st boost to finish the job. I agree. We need another right tackle. We need a solid wide receiver. I do think we need a little bit more depth at linebacker as well. And hell yeah, man, I'm all in on the Honey Badger if it can happen. But the number one offensive player that we need, or the number one free agent the Raiders need to go out and get, I'm telling you, it's Darrell Williams. That's your right tackle. What up, Lewis? Could you see the Raiders taking Jordan Davis in the draft? If he was available, I would love him, but Jordan Davis is probably going to be the very first defensive tackle off the board from Georgia. I don't see him escaping round one. And if he does, he'd be a player that I would consider trading up for. It's just, it's not going to happen. I know we're talking a lot about wide receivers early on in the show, so how about this? Raiders went out, they signed DeMarcus Robinson in free agency. Who do you have more confidence in this year? Is it Bryan Edwards type BA? Is it DeMarcus Robinson type DR? The third year is usually known as the breakout year for receivers, so hopefully Edwards can take that next step. And if Edwards lives up to the hype and can be that dude that I've seen the tape of, then I will say the Raiders have a top five receiving unit. Let's go to Michael. Love the picture. What do you think about taking Kevin Austin Jr.? Calvin Austin's going to go like in the top three rounds. He's speedy receiver, definitely a little bit undersized. But again, he's not going to be available in the seventh. So realistically, the real question here is, do you take Calvin Austin Jr. In the third round? And yes, I like the talent, but I also don't see him being available in the third round. I would rather have Sky Moore over Calvin, but in seventh round, yes, of course. Let's go to Rami. What do you think it would take to trade for an early second in the 30 or 40 range? So, Rami, I would tell you to go ahead and look at my trade video that I did last week around five trades that the Raiders could do. And it's not just trying to figure out the exact trade because that's almost impossible. It's about showing y'all what it would probably cost to get up that high in the draft. So go ahead, check it out. I gave you a bunch of different ideas, and I gave you a few different trades to get up into the top 40. So seriously, go check it out. If you guys are going to plan on watching the NFL draft, yo, there is one place to watch it and one place only. That's at Chat Sports. The link is below. YouTube.com/ChatSportsTV. Live all seven rounds, all 3 days. The picks are going to be here on YouTube before you see them on ESPN. That is for Just Win Babies. Believe it, baby. Join the team. Hit that subscribe button. Turn on those notifications. That way, you know, right when we go live. Let's go to Javier. It was wide receiver Calvin Austin. supposedly ran a 4.03. No, he didn't. Some people might say that he ran certain things, but I saw 4.32. I'm going to believe what I saw. And to run a 4.03, somebody's juicing the clock. It's not that it's physically impossible, but, I mean, you're talking about Usain Bolt at top speed type of speed. Like, no, Calvin Austin did not run a 4.03. If that happened, then I suppose he ran a 4.5. What up, Untouchable Raider? Thoughts on Christian Harris trading to the second could fall, and I heard we are getting some comp. So comp picks next year are definitely a possibility, and it's because some of the coaches that have been hired at some other spots, so that could happen. Thoughts on Christian Harris trading to the second? No. I don't see the Raiders going up into the second. So, and then in terms of the comp picks, it's why the Raiders might not do anything until after the draft because it might mess up some of their comp picks. So what about this, y'all? There's two rumors going around right now around A.J. Brown and even Terry McLaurin. Terry McLaurin, there's even some rumors around him potentially sitting out, and I like McLaurin a lot. He's actually one of my favorite wide receivers out there, and I get it. This is the Raiders report, but you know what? I like talking about big names as well. So who's the better wide receiver just from an NFL standpoint? Is that A.J. Brown or is it Terry McLaurin? Type A-B, F-A-B, or T-M for McLaurin. Let's go to Ambitious Cowboy. Do you think the Raiders give up the third pick for draft capital? It depends who's available. Like, it's a shitty answer, but it's the God honest truth. If there's certain players and if there's certain teams that want to trade up, if I was Las Vegas, I would be okay trading back because there's a lot of good depth in this year's class. And I would say the picks between 86 to 106 aren't really all that different. So if a team wants to move up, I'm okay with it. I'm cool with it. And if the Raiders want to go up to get a certain player that they have really, really high on their board, again, I'm okay with it. Let's go to Sal. You said no to A.J. Brown, but what about Terry McLaurin? It's funny that you said that. I would say A.J. Brown is a better wide receiver if you're looking for a one. However, Terry McLaurin, I would make the argument, is a better fit with Derek Carr in this offense. Like, if you're telling me right now, ma'am, you can add Terry McLaurin next to Davante Adams with Hunter Renfrow and Darren Waller, this is the best offense in all of football. I believe McLaurin's going to end up getting his deal. I mean, I've said a few times that if you put Terry McLaurin with the Buffalo Bills, he's Stephon Diggs. That's how talented I think McLaurin is. Well, let's go to Jersey. What is the possibility of the Raiders to get James Bradberry if he gets released? If he gets released, I'll say one of the top teams most likely to go out and get Bradberry will be the Raiders. And I still put this. If you were to tell me the top five teams most likely to go out and get him, the Silver and Black should absolutely be into that equation. Bradberry has a lot of connections with Patrick Graham, has good connections with some of our defensive backs coaches as well. And I know he fits the system. And the Raiders do need another corner. Not that I don't like Trayvon Mullen, but you got to face it. Bradberry and Rocky Sin would be a good cornerback duo in the AFC West, which is absolutely loaded. Now, guys, we get a lot of questions here on these shows, and we've been live on YouTube for almost 2 hours now, so we got a lot of questions. If I didn't get to your question, you can always hit me up on Locals. DM me at RaidersReport.locals.com. That's the link. But I will check my DMs. I promise you, I will check my DMs. Becoming a member is 100% free. And if you want to see a shout-out on future shows, I'm going to start giving more shout-outs to the members over on Locals because it's free to become a member. If you want even more exclusive content on top of all of that, then you can become a supporter. But shout-out to these 7 people here. I put out a post earlier in the week about, hey, if you shout out your area code, I'll go ahead and give you a shout-out on the Raiders Report. Locals is about putting more power in the hands of the watchers. So if that interests you, become a member, RaidersReport.locals.com. Let's go to Aaron. What's up? Chargers was said to be a location for a trade for Deebo Samuel. How much of a chance of this happening would it be? No. It's not going to happen, man. Deebo Samuel's not coming to the Raiders. Sorry. Oh, Chargers. Wait, Deebo to the Chargers? Oh, okay. The Chargers, sorry. I saw Raiders totally glance over the Chargers part. Debo's not going to get traded. And if he ends up getting traded, I would be really, really shocked about it. I mean, they got Keenan Allen, Mike Williams. They might decide to go all in. Honestly, I think if Deebo goes anywhere, this might be a crazy thing to say. I think it's the Miami Dolphins. I think he just rejoins one of his old buddies in Mike McDaniel, who's now just creating an all-star team down there in Miami with their wide receivers. Let's go to rdog_76. What is your best way of addressing right tackle, draft, or free agency, and who? It's right tackle, it's Darrell Williams, and it's not close to me. Not only do I want to go out and get a veteran at right tackle, it's because I want to make sure that the right tackle that I'm getting helps Alex Leatherwood materialize and helps him groom into being a solid right guard. That's why you go out, you get a solid right tackle, somebody like Darrell Williams. What up, Ryan? Okay, do you want to trade for what you don't want to trade for a wide receiver? Excuse me. What about signing Jarvis Landry? So if you're depending on when you're watching this video, Jarvis Landry is visiting the Saints on Tuesday. So if he ends up going there, I'm sorry. If not, though, I mean, Jarvis would be another really good fit in this offense. The issue is this. I think the amount of money it's going to cost to go out and get Jarvis Landry is the same amount of money it's going to cost to get somebody like Darrell Williams. Darrell Williams is going to help out the team a lot more, somebody like Jarvis. But however, I'll ask you all, why for yes or and for no, should the Raiders go ahead and sign Jarvis Landry? Get those votes in. Should the Raiders go out and sign Jarvis Landry? Final question from Cameron Sproul. We gave a first and a second for Devontae. Would you give next year's first and second and our fifth and our 2 fifth rounders this year for Debo? Here's the issue. 49ers probably say no. I mean, if I was the 49ers and I saw what Tyreek Hill went for and I saw what Devontae Adams went for, I would want first round picks this year. Like, next year's first and a second probably isn't enough. So the 49ers would say no. I understand that would make this Raiders offense insane. But this might sound crazy. I'm probably going to say no, though, to this deal, because there's only one football, and you can only give it around to so many people. So I'll say no. When does Raiders report throwing a first annual National Raider Nation cookout? It's a good question. I did plan on trying to get together with some Raider fans here in Dallas, and it is still something that I want to do. It's just we are busy, and if it does end up happening, it's either going to be in May, June, or July. Those are usually our down times. But I'll make you a deal. If you live in the Dallas area, I promise you if we end up doing a cookout, if we end up just doing something, a little get-together at a restaurant or something like that, I'll let you all know. That way we can end up doing it. So, Ambitious Cowboy, if that sounds good to you, and hopefully everyone can go ahead and they can join in.